Hi everyone, thanks so much for coming back to 1MinuteDigital.com. Today I'm going to do an abbreviated version of the previous tutorial where we designed this entire flyer for a realtor. I'm just going to show you in this tutorial how to crop and resize and align images. Those were the basic points of this flyer. It's very easy to do, you just have to know a couple of things. So sometimes when you place your image into Illustrator by going to File, Place, they're all different sizes, and so when you bring them in, they're kind of loopy, they're all over the place, and you want to get them exactly the way you want them. The way to do that is I'm going to zoom in so you can see, select your image. Now if you do not see these white boxes in the corners, go up to View and select Show Bounding Box. You need that bounding box showing so you can more easily grab your corners. So with your image selected, I want you to hover over the corner till you see it makes a diagonal line with two arrows. Hold down Shift, click, and drag. Now that keeps it in proportion and you can make it any size you want that way. If you don't hold down Shift, it will go out of proportion and you don't want that to happen. So hold down Shift, hover, hold down Shift, click, and drag until we have it filling up the entire area for our flyer. So there's our first image that's sized the way we want it. Now we have all of these other images. I'm just going to move this out of the way so we can see. And we want them to be exactly the same size and aligned perfectly. So first thing, let's hold down Shift, hover, click, and drag them till they're about the same size, just so we can deal with them more easily. Let's hold down Shift, click, and drag. Hold down Shift, click, and drag. They're about the same size now, so we can see what we're doing. Now we want to create four boxes actually going across here because we want to make them about a quarter of the size going from left to right. See, that one wasn't all the way done. Here we go. And so you can either, selecting your rectangle tool, click anywhere on your artboard and create an exactly 2 inches wide by 1.5 inches high. If you want to do it that way, I usually use my eye just to kind of get to where I want to be. So I'm going to go ahead and draw a rectangle approximately the size I think that will work. There we go. And I'm in my color picker here, I'm going to make it a white stroke with no fill. That's going to serve as a frame. Now zooming in, with that frame selected, you can see it there, select your image and kind of move it until you see your frame is cropping out most of that image there for you. So we've got as much of that image as we can in there and we want to make it this size. So selecting the stroke now, copy it to your pasteboard by hitting Command-C or Edit, Copy. Now selecting both, hit Command and the number 7 on your keyboard. That crops the image to the stroke that was on top of it. That's Command and the number 7. Now moving over to the next one, remember we copied that stroke. We're just going to paste it again. There it is. We're going to do our next image. Select with your black arrow. Move it around the image. Now we need to make this one a little bit bigger. Hold down Shift, click, and drag. Move it to where you want to crop it. Now selecting both, hit Command and the number 7 on your keyboard. Now these two images are exactly the same size. Let's go to our next one. Let's paste that stroke there again. These are all kind of on top of each other, but I'll align them better in a moment. Make your image, get as much of that image as you can. Select both, hit Command and the number 7. Now this is a Mac, I believe on a PC it is Control and the number 7. And we've got one more to do. We want to make everything the same size. Let's paste that frame, bring it over here. And let's make this a little smaller. There we go. And hit Command and the number 7 with both of those selected. Now we have them all the same size. We just need to align them like this. So selecting all four of them, go up here to your alignment tools. It's not labeled here, but if you hover over it, it says Align to Artboard. Make sure Align to Artboard is selected. Then hover over until you find your Horizontal Align Center tool and click there. That puts them all together on the same center line. Keep going until you find the Vertical Align Center. Click there. That puts them exactly one on top of another. It looks like there's just one, but there's actually four there. Now keep going. We're not done yet until you find your Distribute tools. Horizontal, Distribute, Left. Click there. And now it brought them all the way across the artboard in exactly the right amount of space. There isn't any space between them. As you can see, the images are too large to have any space. So if that happens to you and you don't want them to butt up against each other, just select them all and do what we did before. Hold down Shift, click, and drag. Make them a little smaller. And then go up with them still selected. Go back up to your Distribute tools and say Horizontal, Distribute, Left. Click there, and there we go. It made them exactly equal distant and brought them over to the right side, or the proper side of the flyer. And now here we have our two, or rather our six images aligned exactly the way we want them for this flyer. Okay, it's that easy, just using clipping masks and that little trick of hovering over it to click and drag to resize your image. I hope that was helpful for you. And again, if you want to see this entire tutorial on how to create this flyer, just find the How to Design a Real Estate Flyer in the Illustrator or the long tutorial section of my YouTube channel. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye.